So we in our laboratory, we're interested in developing a new way of creating stem cells, but in this case, the stem cells would be from a cell or skin cell derived from a patient. So that way, the stem cells we create, they would be compatible if we transplant these tissues back into patient. So one way to do it is to take a skin cell, for example, nucleus, but to make it stem cell, we have to have a compatible cytoplasm. And we know that actually from animal studies that eggs, actually the cytoplasm has this capacity to basically to turn any cell nucleus that we put inside into stem cells. So the procedure is called somatic cell nuclear transfer. And we perfected in the past this procedure in the monkey model, so it's a non-human primate, very close to humans. And so we were interested if we could use now this technique to apply to human eggs. And in the past, for more than 10 years, many laboratories actually tried to accomplish that unsuccessfully. And we've been able to produce these stem cells very efficiently in this study. And the way we did it, because we understood how this process works. So the technique is pretty simple, but our understanding how this cytoplasm converts and what the conditions has to be met were unclear. So in this study, we highlighted the importance of some of the factors that you have to maintain in this egg cytoplasm. And by understanding that, we applied now this technique to human eggs, and we've been able to produce very efficiently stem cells now from a patient's skin cell. So right now we can make, of course, this early embryo-like stem cells from a patient's skin cell. And hopefully by more research, by understanding now how to make different tissues now from these stem cells. So these stem cells are kind of very early unprogrammed cells, but they have, of course, capacity to become any other cell type. And so the task is now to make these different cells, for example, neurons or hepatocytes or blood cells, whatever the patients need, to produce in a petri dish, basically in the laboratory, and then transplant these tissues and cells back into patient, already mature these cells, so that we could treat some of the diseases caused by lack or dysfunction of these cells in the body.